Howdy folks, it's Diecast Wolfie here again, and welcome back to Sprint Cars Road to Knoxville. Last episode, we made another attempt at the sprint car realm with a much faster race car, and I think we blew it. I think we blew it. We had the opportunity, we were tuning on the Bandit, and we could not get it done. Oh boy. Still, only a $27,000 car, even though we've dumped, like 60 grand in that thing. Let's go ahead and jump right into the next event, which would be a pro modified event. Player 2's under control. We'll just go ahead and know that. We're going to skip practice. Actually, tell you what. Let me see. No, I don't want to retire. Rip. I was going to just go ahead and pull Farley Ferris from the modified position because he can't run any of the events. Because if you watch the event, if you select him to qualify, you have to watch his qualifying performance. It's so backwards how they did it. Like, I understand they were trying to make it where two people can compete in a career mode together, which I think is a really cool idea, but I think they kind of forgot that, hey, make it, the ability that you could actually own a second car and not have to have an actual controller, another guy driving the car for you and stuff like that. That's what I would have, done, but hey, it is what it is. It's still a really good dirt game. Anyways, this is a very odd track. I don't know how good we'll do here. It reminds me of I don't know what you would call it. It's so weird looking. I like it, though. I like it how, the grandstands feel like they're a little bit higher up than the racetrack. Kind of like that, man. If it makes you feel like you're deep in the ground racing. I don't know where we qualify. We'll go ahead and skip qualify for him. Qualify 23rd. Oh, my God. Can we repair our car? No damage. Wow. We are going to have to earn our way in, man. Here we go, guys. Here we go. We're going to have to earn our way, man. 11th position. We have the points lead. We need a good finish, man. And the last modified race, we actually won. And, of course, my capture card glitched out. Just crashed. So, I do apologize for that, but we did win, that's why you've seen a spark in our earnings, so I do have that to prove it. You've seen the spark in our earnings before we bought the part, fuel injectors for our sprint car. Anyways, after our win at Eldora, we're back in the Pro Modified Series, digging, scratching, and clawing here in the heat race. We qualified terrible, but I feel like our race trim speed's going to be more replicative, or a better replication of our actual car handling, and I'm noticing people are like running the outside here, which is kind of interesting, kind of different. I like that a lot. It's kind of cool seeing the cars run the outside line instead of just hugging the bottom all the time. Whoa, Nelly, I did not want to take him out there. Oh, come on, man, guy's busting my chops. Come on, if we can get a few more positions, we might be able to skip. Oh, nope. I can't make it stick, man. Just cannot make it stick. Well, they're going to make contact. Sail it on in there. Oh, Nelly. Not going to be enough. Come on. I just can't do it, man. I just don't have the speed. That guy is just too fast, man. He's way too fast. Let's try to run the outside and see if we can pick up a little extra speed. Well, there's two cars right there. That's what we need. Oh, I didn't want to make contact there, but oh well. We're going to have to set up for one corner. We're going to have to hit him. Come on, we got to run. Yep. Just not enough. Fifth place. We'll take it. That guy ahead of us, though, he was really fast. He's going to be a contender for the win tonight. Did we make it? No, we did not. I don't think we did, no. We're going to have to fight it out in the B main. Yep, just shy of it. Wait, did we make it? No, I think we did, actually. Never mind. Yeah, we did make it. Sweet, so top five gets in. Okay, cool. I was worried, man, that top four was the only one to get in. I don't know, all the entry points, so to speak. Because I think B-Main's top four? Or and the Heat's top... I don't know. It's weird. Anyways, green flag here tonight. It's a 30-lap event here. Holy cow, man. Get your popcorn, get your snacks on deck. It's going to be a long race. And we are just getting just bamboozled back here. We're just getting flat out disrespected in the back of the pack. That's cool. I love when just AIs just do the same tricks we do on the other AIs. We just completely sideswipe them, and they're going to get hung up there. We'll go around them. Now, it looks like the outside groove is the fastest way around here. So we're gonna have to just dig in and run the outside groove. Gotta adapt to the racetrack. Man, look at that run there. Ooh, 73 on the inside. A little bit of contact there. Oh, Nelly. Dirt racing on Diecast Buffet. Let me tell you about it. Let's see if we can sell it on in there. Nope. Bam! Man, we are just digging hard. And we're just on lap 5. And we've already seen this much of contact, action, side-by-side racing. This is going to be a good one, folks. Let's see if we can try to get a good finish tonight. Hold our points lead as we're going to door slam the 72. There's that hot rod right in front of us. That bluish-yellow car. Ooh, we're going to take advantage of that, use him as a pick. Ooh, we are already in the top 5 tonight, guys, and we're not even... We're like just a quarter in. Got a long event going here. Long race. We're already up to the top 3. Car's got a little bit of damage in the right front, but not enough to slow us down. We can keep digging. The outside groove is no question the right way to go around here. They got that one. Definitely got some grip up there. You can kind of nail on and just kind of dig around. I love how the dirt's just slinging up in this track. Very loose, not packed in well. I like that. I like dirt's flying. That's what I want to see. That's what I wish the Eldora trucks would do. I wish they wouldn't pack it in so much. I know it makes for better racing, but I want to see dirt-covered trucks, man. I don't want them to look like they're perfectly, you know, look like they're almost pristine. I want dirt all over that thing. Of course, the sponsors might not like that too much, but heck, who cares, man? Or just running the outside groove. Making a run on the leader here. I want to try to pass him clean, though. I don't want to wreck him. I'm just trying to pass him clean. See if we can try that. Oh, we're already around him. He's going to try underneath. Whoa, we're going to get hung up on the bottom. The bottom is not as fast, but that is a clean pass for the lead here. Approaching the halfway point tonight. Oh, my Lord. It's been a fun race. I mean, we've had to fight our way through the field. Coming back from, 15th place, I believe? I mean, we've just had to fight our way through the field. The AI isn't the fastest here. They kind of got hung up a few times, and we took advantage of it, you know? When opportunities present themselves, you have to be willing and able to capitalize on that opportunity. You know, whether it's fuel mileage at Fontana or, you know, cars beating and banging and getting woed up at a dirt track, you got to be able to capitalize on the opportunities at hand. We are just all over this track. This is what I like, man. I like these outside groove ones. They're fun. It's not always just, generic run the inside line. I like being able to wash up and just kick the throttle. Like, you wash up, kick the throttle, and you just build up that just adrenaline off the corner. It's fun, man. And plus, it opens up the opportunity for slide jobs. Because if you go underneath, if you can just nail the underneath and just barely get underneath them as we almost wreck, if you can just slide up in front of them, then you can complete the pass. But the inside cannot be ran as a consistent racing line. There's just not enough speed up there. But we are pulling away from the field tonight. Shades of Eldora, of just how fast we are. And we're trying to get our Pro Modified Championship. That's what I want. I want to win the title, man. That's what I want to do. Use a tear-off there. Try to keep our screen as clear as possible for the recording. Hopefully my capture card doesn't die again. I wish they'd pay us $100 for every car we lap, because, man, that'd be nice. Pay the repair fees for that. Ooh, Nelly's going to wash up right in front of us. Whoa, going to correct it, man. I really like the Pro Modifieds. They're much easier to drive, and they're big and bulky. That's what I like. I'm a stock car guy. I love stock cars. I love, you know, banger racing, stuff like that. There we go. Look at that. Look at that opportunity right there. Slide up in front of him. Whoa! Man, smoking a bandit on the outside here. Huge rush of speed. He's going to be underneath. Yep, there he is. He's going to wash up. Gets loose and just slides up and just loses his momentum. I feel like we're racing for the lead right now, but we're actually up front racing lap traffic. It's exciting. It's fun trying to get around these guys clean, because you don't want to damage your equipment, but at the same time, you want to get around them quick enough so you don't get slowed up. See, we're running the inside groove. Yeah, it's a short way around, but if you don't have a drastic advantage on the guy on the outside, you're not going to get around him. Like, if second place is on the outside and you run the inside, it's going to take a sensational lap to get around him. But if you're racing against lap traffic, you can do that because they're so off speed. Like, right there, we shouldn't have tried that, but we did. Now, that guy was probably running for 8th and 9th place. So he didn't have a terrible race car, but not a great race car. It's okay, though. It's okay. Live and learn. Meanwhile, we're approaching lap 26 tonight. It's been a long one, but it's been a fun one as well. I've noticed that you just don't get that speed off the inside, man. You really need the outside to kind of just kickstart your throttle and make a little contact with the wall there, but... Heck yeah. Just a few more corners, and it's payday. Whoa, Nelly. Trying to win this one for y'all guys. Dirt racing on Diecast Buffet. Come on, come on, come on. I want to get around this car ahead of us. That's what I want to do. I don't know if I'll be able to. Whoa, he's going to get big bobbled there. We're going to have a good run on the outside. He's going to wash up in front of us, make a little bit of a contact there. Oh, okay, okay, okay. I see how you want to race, bud. I ain't worried about him. Because guess what? We're coming home with a trophy. He ain't coming home with crap. That's another win. Back-to-back, we won at Eldora. Now we win here at Pick-and-Back Raceway. Dominated, man. Dominated. Whew. Big paycheck for the race team. Your current sponsorship has expired. Check for others. Yes, finally. Let's get Norman's Race Photography on the race car. Be extra money for the race team, which is always a good thing, guys. Always a good thing. So we got 26K in the bank, so you know what that means. We're about to get a maxed out sprint car. Let's go ahead and get the weight kit, 1,500 pound weight kit. We'll go ahead and purchase that. There we go, 19 grand in the bank. Gone. Whew. Another win. We got to repair the car. Let's see, Alamo. We're going to go ahead and repair that. Nice. Nice, nice, nice. How much would it take to get another midget car? Let's see. Because I'm thinking, is he pull whoever's running Charlotte and put him in the midget for the rest of the season? I think that's what we're going to do. Because we need to get another car running. So we're going to go ahead and get another midget running. Let's see. Yeah, we'll go ahead and run that. I'll buy that. Let's come up with a name of the car. Alright, so we got Delta. So we got Betsy, Delta, Alamo, Charlotte, and Bandit. So what we're going to do is we're going to move our spare driver that had Farley Ferris. He's a really, you know, pretty good rating for his driver. We're going to move him over to Delta. Yes, I want to move him over because he's not racing at all. And I want to make sure, you know, because we're paying him $1,000 per event. You see what I'm saying? So move him over to a car that he could actually compete in. So he'll be racing Delta. So we'll have two midget cars, three-quarter midgets. Can we upgrade anything on them right now? Let's see. What can we get them? What can we get them? Okay, we can't afford that. Can't afford that. We can get the titanium rotors, and we can get them the fuel injectors. We'll go ahead and get them that, so the car will get a little bit more speed in it. I would switch the driver out. Let's see. I don't know if we can switch the cars around. I don't know. Let's see. Manage team. Let's see. I don't think we could swap the drivers. I don't know if we could put Montooth in Farley's car. Let's see. No. We can't do that, unfortunately. Alright, guys. So that's going to be the end of this episode. Make sure to give the video a thumbs up and to subscribe. Thank you all so much for watching. Hope you're having a great one out there. And Diecast Buffet signing off.